They move everything from our clothes to toys and electronics through the ports and into the marketplace. But a lot of those goods won't be making it to our stores if longshoremen at more than a dozen ports from Maine to Texas go on strike. That's what could happen by Sunday if a deal can't be reached between the major shipping companies and a union representing nearly 15,000 longshoremen.
The impact would be great, obviously on the dollar value side, on the cargo handling side, but also on the job side, because again, these ports are major economic generators.
Richard Scheer of the Maryland Port Administration and others say the economic damage from a strike would reach well beyond the docks.
Everybody from your mom and pop retailer to your farmer to the trucking company who has to go in and pick up the containers at the ports. So this is going to be felt not just at the local economy at the port, but nationwide for everybody else who relies on these ports to move their commerce.
Coming at the same time as the fiscal cliff impasse, it's a potentially devastating 1-2 punch for the U.S. economy. Neither the Longshoremen's Union nor the alliance representing the shipping companies would give us anyone to speak on camera. But officials with knowledge of the negotiations say it boils down to one issue.
The key sticking point is over those large containers and the payments that longshoremen get for them. The shipping companies pay royalties to the longshoremen for the containers based on their weight. But the shipping companies now want to freeze those royalty payments for current longshoremen and eliminate them completely for future hires.
The longshoremen say those royalties are designed to make up for jobs lost to automation. A strike would only affect ports that handle containers, not other cargo like automobiles. But if the shipping companies lock out the longshoremen,
that would impact more than just containers. That would impact all cargoes at ports. So that would have obviously a much more impactful reaction.
Just how impactful? Scheer says that East Coast and Gulf Coast ports handled about $55 billion worth of cargo in an average month this year. Candy?
So, Brian, I have to imagine that retail companies and others who want those goods off the ships and in their stores have to be plenty worried. Do they have a plan B to move those goods if there's a strike?
Yes, some of them do. Clothing companies, footwear companies, other retailers, some of them have arranged to have their goods, their merchandise shipped early this year to maybe minimize the cost of this. Others have arranged to use West Coast ports and then get their merchandise by rail or truck to the East Coast. But both of those alternatives would drive up the cost to consumers of all these goods.